Hello my fellow Fujoshis, this is BL Fan Edits and I'm back with another video. Today I'm listing down 16 BL side couples that gave us a serious case of second lead syndrome. These are couples who managed to steal the spotlight from the main couple with their superior chemistry and charisma. They made us fall in love with them. So without further ado, let's list down 16 side couples that gave us second lead syndrome. Pok and Tong's hot and cold relationship captured the hearts of viewers of Gen Y the series. Despite it being a multi-couple series, Pok and Tong's stormy romance managed to blow away the audience. Their relationship started off very subdued. Tong's friends ask him to tutor Pok as he is a sports quota student who is great at swimming but not that great in academics. Pok is attracted to Tong and Tong also feels a connection with him. However, due to some misunderstandings created by their friend Sandy, Pok feels like Tong has wronged him. Although he hates Tong, he can't control his heart, which is drawn towards Tong. Pok asks Tong to be his college roommate in order to keep an eye on him. However, that leads him to come even closer to Tong. This toxic relationship between Pok and Tong stole the show for me. I'm looking forward to how their relationship progresses in season 2. Zhao Gang and Si Chi's sweet relationship was the perfect antidote to Yujin and Shile's complicated relationship. Their sweet and sincere moments gave us a much needed relief from all the drama happening in the main couple's life. They had so many fluffy moments throughout the series and their story progressions seemed much more natural than the main couple. Zhao Gang is a cafe owner who has had difficulties in his past relationships that have made him wise and insightful. People always go to him for advice and he is a caring person who takes shy and naive Si Chi under his wing. Si Chi falls for Zhao Gang as he sees how uncomplicated and soothing Zhao Gang is as a person, and Zhao Gang falls in love with Si Chi for his innocence and purity. I have to say, I'm quite cross with the producers for not giving Kim and Ball the screen time they deserved in Nitiman the series. In my opinion, their chemistry is much better than the main couple. Although they had only limited scenes, their screen presence and chemistry stole the hearts of the audience. Although I'm still confused as to who Kim liked because he seemed to have chemistry with all the boys, but Kim and Ball's relationship is what stood out the most to me. Kim has a crush on Ball since high school, and when he sees Ball for the first time in college, he is mesmerized by his charming good looks. Ball, on the other hand, is clueless about Kim's feelings for him. Ball's boyish charm and innocence attract Kim and Kim tries to get closer to him. It will be exciting to see their relationship progress in the second season. Pitch and Bank are the fun, quirky couple that you can't help but adore. In my humble opinion, Pitch and Bank's chemistry was superior than Sun and Skies. Their energy seemed to match well and they looked much more compatible than the main couple. Pitch once brought Bank home after a drunk night out. Since then, he couldn't help but feel weird around him. When the whole group goes to a CSR trip, Pitch and Bank's feelings grow and we get to see quite few fluffy moments between them. The kiss they shared seemed natural and the chemistry kept flowing throughout the series. It's a shame that this series has only 8 episodes because I would have liked to see more of Pitch and Bank. I think this is another BL where the main couple didn't do it for me. I will be honest, I was yawning and skipping through episodes until Pure and Folk story came in and then the whole show became suddenly interesting. First of all, I love the fact that Pure was shown as openly bisexual in this series, and although the couple had just 2 or 3 episodes together, their relationship progression looked very genuine and organic. I liked the fact that they did not show Pure completely transforming his Casanova lifestyle after meeting Folk, but there was a gradual shift in his feelings and he kept learning from his mistakes. Although Folk is a newbie actor, he still acted better than the male couple and his chemistry with Pure was outstanding. Overall, this show was made bearable to watch only because of Pure and Folk. Fu and Cao's relationship was like a breath of fresh air in Oxygen the series. Fu and Cao's acting was far superior than Solo and Gui's. Their relationship was sweet and wholesome. Although they had limited scenes, the story progression was gradual and natural. Cao was able to break down Fu's walls little by little, and Fu was able to embrace his childish side when he was with Cao. Although their relationship was not shown as very serious, there were moments where we could see real heart-to-heart conversations and intimate moments. I have heard that a production company has picked up Nitrogen the series, which will focus on Fu and Cao's relationship. I think that series will be much more interesting to watch. Ja and First Ship became very famous after they acted as Leo and Fiat in Than Type Season 2. Leo and Fiat had such a natural chemistry on screen that the audience couldn't help but be drawn to this side couple. We can all agree that the only saving grace of Than Type Season 2 were the side couples, and Leo and Fiat managed to steal the spotlight from the legendary couple Than and Type. This series is proof that you don't need steamy and sexy scenes to be liked by the audience. The way you vibe with each other and the sincerity you show on screen is enough to let the audience know about your talents as actors. It is no surprise to me that Ja and First got their own series now, which is the continuation of Leo and Fiat's love story in Than Type Season 2. The name of this new series is Don't Say No. I've already watched the first couple of episodes and it's really good. I'm looking forward to watching the rest of the series. Let's be honest, nobody can actually compare the level of on-screen chemistry Tae and Niu have, but Sun and Mork come pretty close to them in terms of chemistry and acting. Pete and Cao will always remain in our hearts as the ultimate BL ship, but we can't deny that Sun and Mork did a pretty solid job as a side couple in Dark Blue Kiss. This series was overall quite well made and interesting throughout. With the addition of good storyline given to Sun and Mork, and their amazing execution, this series became one of the best Thai BLs of all time. I hate to say it, but their story was more interesting than Pete and Cao's. I love that Mork is shown as a hard ass and a thug, but in front of Sun, he is like a delicate flower who needs to be nurtured and loved to grow to its full potential. Sun shows him compassion and care, which warms Mork's heart and makes him fall in love with Sun. I'm still waiting for these two to have their own series because their chemistry is outstanding and they look so good together on screen. We can all agree that with Z and Saint on screen, it is very hard to concentrate on the side couple. But Saifa and Zon managed to grab the attention of the viewers with their wonderful chemistry and fluffy moments. Once their relationship progresses into romance, it is wonderful to see their cute intimate moments and how much Saifa loved and cared for Zon. Zon had a lot of comedic elements in his role which could have come across as cringy, but he's such a good actor that he managed to make his character believable and natural. Their cute and awkward moments were in perfect contrast to Fighter and Tutor's intense and heated moments. Although Saifa and Zon didn't get to have as many scenes as Fighter and Tutor due to the COVID situation, they still managed to win our hearts with their cute and sweet moments. Even though Tul and Gonhin's relationship was not explored to its full potential in Love by Chance 2, they still managed to steal everyone's heart with limited screen time. Their interactions seemed genuine and both actors had great chemistry on screen. It shows in Tul's actions how much he loves Gonhin and the regret he feels for letting go of him all those years ago. I wish Tul and Gonhin had more scenes together because their story was really interesting and deserved a series on its own. Both Tul and Gonhin are extremely handsome, so their kissing moments were beautiful to watch. I wish these two have more BLs together because I'm not satisfied with such a short number of scenes between them. Tin and Can were definitely the show stealers of Love by Chance the series. Although I do agree that A and Pete had lovely on-screen chemistry, Tin and Can also had amazing chemistry and made a big impact with their performance. Tin and Can ship became so popular that Mean and Plan appeared in two other BL series as a couple, Two Wish and Love by Chance Season 2, which focused solely on them. Tin is the son of one of the most richest men in Bangkok. Therefore, he acts like an entitled brat. He looks down upon everyone. But little does anyone know that Tin has trust issues and has never experienced parental love. His own brother has backstabbed him, so he feels like no one in this world is genuine and everyone is out to get him. He's lonely but hides his loneliness in his cold demeanor. Can, on the other hand, is a carefree guy who is loved by everyone because of his fun-loving and outgoing personality. He is a little naive and gullible, which makes him too pure for this world. When Tin and Can meet, there is an instant hatred between the two. But slowly, Can's innocence starts to grow on Tin, and Tin starts falling in love with him. Their love story is one of the best I've seen in any BLs, and I'm glad they received all the love because they really deserved it. I was really invested in Ming and Kit's storyline since Two Moon Season 1. Although I always imagined Ming and Kit as Kim and Copter, but Chen and Nine also had awesome chemistry and visuals. First of all, both Chen and Nine are very good actors. They immersed themselves into their character and made Ming and Kit their own. Ming is a university moon who has a history of being a serial dater, but as soon as he saw Kit, he fell in love. Kit is Ming's senior. He's afraid to commit to Ming because of his reputation. But Ming breaks down Kit's walls with his patience and love. He shows Kit that he only has eyes for him. Ming and Kit had better storyline than the main couple, and their chemistry on on-screen presence also stood out more than the main couple. Two Moons 2 is one of those series where side couples have much more interesting storylines than the main couple. Don't get me wrong, the main couple were cute, but they did not have much of a storyline. Fourth and Beam is one such couple that I was instantly drawn towards. Their relationship started off as a one-night stand, but Fourth realized that he had feelings for Beam and it was not just pure sex. Beam, on the other hand, didn't want to ruin their years of friendship, so he ignored his feelings for Fourth. But nothing remained same after the one-night stand. Fourth pursued Beam with honest heart, and Beam also admitted his feelings for Fourth. I wish this couple had more dramas together because they have amazing on-screen visuals and chemistry. Make Our Days Count is a series where I can say both couples stood out in their own right and had been given interesting storylines. Lu Jigang is a cafe shop owner who likes to frequent at a gym which is owned by the cousin of high school student Sun Bo Xiang. Sun Bo has a crush on Jigang and he admires him from afar. Sun Bo slowly gathers courage to approach Jigang, but Jigang rejects him because he's young and also because Jigang has a bad relationship history and he doesn't want to repeat that again. But Sun Bo is persistent and makes Jigang believe that he will never leave him. They are one of the most unproblematic couple in BL history. They even get married in History 4 Close to You. Taiwanese BL ships are usually of very high standard, but Sun Bo and Jigang are on whole another level. Ram and King were the main reason I enjoyed watching My Engineer. To be honest, I really disliked the main couple and the only thing keeping me interested was the Ram and King storyline. The opposite personalities of Ram and King makes them a very attractive pair. Ram is an introvert who doesn't like to interact with someone he's not close to, while King is an extrovert who loves chatting to everyone. Their interactions were endearing to watch and the way they cared for each other in difficult times were very heartfelt. Their quirky personalities stole the show for me. I saved the best for last. Bone Frame? Need I say more? I mean, how can a side BL couple become more famous than the main BL couple? Bone Frame are regarded as one of the pillars of the BL industry and for good reason. Their chemistry was not just good in the drama, but also in fan meets and events, this couple always stood out and became the center of attention. Win is the vice president of a swimming club in the university. Team is a gifted swimmer who joins the club. Win was attracted to Team from the beginning and kept teasing him to get his attention. Win and Team develop a deep friendship that turns into romance once Team realizes that Win is his safe place and that Win is serious about their relationship and not just joking around. So these were 16 side couples that I feel were better than the main couple in terms of acting, chemistry, storyline and screen presence. Do share your opinions in the comment box below, and if you liked my video, don't forget to subscribe, like and share my video. I will see you all in my next video. Bye!